Welcome to my virtual classroom, where we are going to start the classes of this course. This is the course teaching strategies based on the science of learning from the University of Santiago, Chile. Well, why are we doing an online course in circumstances that have we learned in these months that there are many problems with online teaching? Doing that caveat, certainly not all the subject of learning has to do with the online, but we take advantage of what we have learned at this time to be able to bring you a course that deals with to rescue the best of virtual teaching models, as you can see here at this virtual room. To be able to teach you this very interesting topic that is the science of learning. Well, where are we going in this course? We are going towards this figure so strange that there is here, that has a background image. It has a brain structure called the hippocampus that has to do with learning and memory, and here in front you have images that have to do with the last modules that we are going to see in this course, which are personalized learning strategies and diversified. But that's going to be much later in this course. For now, we are going to enter the agenda for today's class, which is that we are going to ask ourselves the question of what is the science of learning, and what are the elements that we have to take into consideration to address that question at the end of this class. Well, first of all, we have to put in perspective this same situation that I am, as a supposed expert, speaking to you, mainly the public, teachers, and how we have to keep in context and carefully the recommendations that this expert or another expert can give you regarding what the learning is. And that is very well described in this book, which is called The 10 Things That Schools Are Wrong, by Mr. Jared Cooney Horvath and Mr. David Bott. Both are Australian, are authors more or less known. What are they saying? Exemplify this situation of communication of experts regarding teachers as follows. So imagine they made a compilation of some congresses, and that was linked to education. So, for example, at the 2019 Australian Institute of Chartered Accountants Congress, 7 out of 8 featured presenters were either practicing accountants or tax attorneys. In parallel, at the Association for Supervision and Development Conference on Teaching Excellence 2019 curriculum, only one of the 13 featured presenters was a classroom teacher, although 7 of the featured presenters were academics. On the other hand, in another example, at the 2019 Australian Medical Law Conference, 8 out of 9 featured presenters, they were practicing doctors or lawyers. Instead, at the conference of the Association Australian for Teaching English of the Year 2019, none of the 11 featured presenters, they were classroom teachers, although 6 were academics. Well, I think that at this point you already got what the message was. This means that while most conferences professionals of a certain topic, people who are experts in the area are invited. When it comes to lecturing for classroom professionals, like you teachers who are viewing this presentation, teachers of classroom, but rather invited people like us, the academics, who are in the, yes, we are in university classrooms, but disconnected most of the time from what happens in the classroom, in a school reality. So what I want to emphasize with this point is that if we want to unpack there in a classroom, the recipe, let's say, is nothing new. It has always been there, that relevant experience for teachers, and that has an impact on their teaching and increasing student learning has always been there.
Que tenga impacto en su docencia
The secret is in the classroom. You don't have to go looking for it in the big research center. It's always there.